year that we enacted our employee health service, it brought about how much of a savings to our insurance?
Well, it's a little bit hard to quantify, but it did assist in helping with our claims and the fact that, you know, we were having to pay out more. It's just kind of a hard number to come up with.
It's been very worthwhile.
But it's been worthwhile. It's been very worthwhile. And it's very popular amongst the staff. One other thing I wanted to point out is to understand that, you know, if we go this route, the risk, our risk grows greater with regards to our lack of flexibility. We won't have any ability to negotiate. Like right now, we're in the process of negotiating with Blue Choice. We would lose that if we signed a four-year agreement. So in other words, I mean, we spoke in Darlington County today, and they were hit this year with, I believe, a 20% increase in health insurance. They were unable to negotiate it. That was just something they had to eat. So we need to also keep that in mind.
Jim, while you're looking at the state plan, I'd like to go back over maybe a 10-year or a 15-year period to see the track record as to what Lynn was talking about, so that can give us an idea of what we're looking at.
Right. The counties that are our size that are currently in it are York, Oreen, Charleston, of the 35. Those are the larger counties that are currently in that.
What kind of experience have they had, similar to Darlington?
We'll look at that. I don't have that right now, but
okay. Maybe follow up on Bill's initial question. We'll probably get that from Tony. But I think the year we implemented the county nurse, I don't think Blue Choice gave us a rate increase that year. So that was pretty
good. Yeah, yeah. So. Well, I mean, it was, I'm just wanting to add in, you know, there was a lot of things that really made that positive.
And I agree with Jim. It's all in the wellness and using the nurse, but getting these problems before they're major problems is what it's all about. Have we discussed with the Y or anyone about some type of deal for our employees with them? Maybe they could join up to get over there and participate in the program?
Yeah, we've had some special offers from various gyms. As a matter of fact, we had one this past week.
Okay.
And as we get those, we pass those along to the employees.
When can we go on the state plan, Jim?
Their plan year is a calendar year. A very interesting phenomenon is happening within this current year. And that is, and some of you may know a whole lot more about this than I do, but the municipalities through the Municipal Association, a number of them have been participating in a health insurance pool that the Municipal Association of South Carolina has been providing. And I'm not telling you anything that's not public record here. A number of those municipalities have decided this year that they can no longer participate in that pool. So the person immediately in charge of dealing with counties and cities and other local governments at the state health plan told me last week that they are currently inundated with enrollments and trying to get folks in by July 1. Their rules, if you will, or their procedure indicates a 90-day period whereby we would say, yes, we want to enter into this four-year agreement. It would be a 90-day period before we would actually have our folks enrolled and participating. Mr. Horton, just to break right to your question, my opinion would be we would need to look at a January 1 date. As I stand here this afternoon.
Who administers the state plan?
The Department of Budget Control.
I mean, who pays for
it? Blue Shield? Yes, sir. Blue Cross Blue Shield.
In the past, they used to have other companies, but is it all just to have Blue Cross Blue Shield?
Well, they have a Cigna HMO plan. That's one of their options.
Okay. They still have it that way.
They do. That HMO plan actually is not an option in every county in the state. But it is an option. It would be an option to our employees.
Does this health insurance have any stipulations about people who have previous disease processes?
If they miss out on our open enrollment, it does.
Okay.
If
fairly similar to most other.
If we do
open enrollment when we first enter, if our coworkers make their selection then they're covered. One of the interesting things that they have is they don't do open enrollment annually, they do it every other year. So if you or I make our selection, we're with them for 2 years.
But new employees in the interim, I mean, they come on.
Right.
When you were talking, Glenn, about, what'd you say, Florence County had experienced 20% increase?
Yeah, Darlington.
That 20% increase, is that something that the county absorbs because of that standard plan thing? So that
yes,
the
ma'am.
Employee rates would never go up during this time. It would just be that the county has to absorb that
20%. That increase, yes, ma'am.
You also will propose or show us the self-insured plan, right?
That's right.
What are the family benefits and restrictions under this plan?
They're fairly similar to our current program. Like I said, the deductibles are lower, the co-pays are right in line, the drug benefits are pretty much in line. I mean, there's some differences, but they're not large differences.
Any provisions of doubling up or offsetting insurances?
That's a good one. I don't recall that I've looked at that. I will make sure we did that.
For instance, if your wife is covered, if you work here, she would have to be insured under hers.
I don't recall reading that in any of their material yet, but I'll make sure I ask them that. Other? So as Mr. Britt indicated, we have also made some examination of self-insurance as a fairly large employer. You can find examples of both private and public of employers that self-fund their health insurance that have a census fairly similar to ours. And we have looked at those examples since we last met. Part of the administration, if you will, or cost that we would see here would be our administration of claims, which is typically a TPA or a third-party administrator. And there are fees associated with that. Typically, those third-party administrators charge those fees per month per employee. So you can just do the math. It's fairly easy to.
An example, you know, Tyndall. You know, we used to have Blue Cross Blue Shield. It's kind of like what we had in the county. And we had a similar number until 08, number of employees that the county had. And before that, we went to self-employed. And we have Blue Cross Blue Shield as our third-party administrator, and like the fees there, they charge us, I forgot what it is, like $4 a person or something to administer the deal. But the incentive is for them to get our you know, to be very careful with our claims. In our case, Blue Cross Blue Shield has no incentive. The more they pay, the more that $1.5 million profit thing that we talked about goes up. So in a case like for us, that's what we've seen in Central. They have to be very, very careful in what they pay out because they're only getting paid by that. And we also, as up there, we have a stop loss. Again, just an example. In Central, we have, I mean, we cover ourselves $125,000 per each in case. And if you're anything over that, we have stop loss insurance, extra insurance. And then we also have an amount on top of that, the worst case scenario. We, for instance, had $25 or $30 million that we could experience in 1 year, something like terrible happened. We buy reinsurance for that, which is very inexpensive, $29,000 or something.
What do you mean with that network participation? What network are we talking about?
Whatever we select, everybody I've talked to says that Blue Cross has the best network. On a self-funded arrangement, you pay them to be part of the network. So that would be a cost that we would have.
But it's, you know, we have found it significantly more economical for us, and also we can manage our plan versus what the county's doing now. You know, we have a general plan, and also the state plan, we don't manage ours. For instance, if we wanted to pay gastric bypasses, you know, if we were setting up our own, we could do that. Under our county plan now, they don't, and we got people who want it, we don't allow it. So they have to go through all the medications and everything else, which is